Welcome everyone. We are in lecture 8 and we are going to discuss shortest job first, which is scheduling technique. Okay. In the previous lecture, we have discussed about first come first serve technique, but there was a problem of convoy effect, right? Convoy effect. In convoy effect, what was the problem? Let's say a process is coming in the ready queue which is having more burst time, like 100 second or 200 second, and other processes which are coming after that, they have only 1 or 2 second burst time, but they have to wait for completion of the process which is having more burst time and scheduled first because it arrived first, right? So the average waiting time for those processes will increase drastically, right? So that convoy effect was creating the problem of high average waiting time for the processes. Fine. To overcome these problems, convoy effect problem, shortest job first approach was proposed. In that technique, criteria is burst time, not arrival time. Criteria is burst time, and mode is non preemptive. Fine. That means at any point of time, at ready state, you will check among the processes which are in ready state, you will check which process is having least burst time. That process will be scheduled to the run state. Fine. Like that, if you are following this criteria, then there will be no any process, right, which is waiting longer time, because if it is having less burst time, it will go first, right? So convoy effect will be overcome by shortest job first. Let's see example so that you can understand this properly. Here let's see. For this example, we will make Gantt chart. Okay. At time zero, right? In ready queue, right? At time zero, at ready queue, which process is ready? Only P1. Only P1 is ready at time 0, then it will go to the run state. Okay. P1 will go in the running state. Fine. What is its burst time? Its burst time is 5. So from 0 to 5, P1 will perform its execution. Remember, this is non-preemptive scheduling. Fine. So if any process is going to running state, then it will perform its operation. No one can preempt it. Fine. So 0 to 5, P1 will perform its execution, and P1 is over now. At 5, P1 is over now. Let's see. At 5, which are processes available at ready queue? At 5, all the processes ready in the ready queue, arrival time is less than 5. That means they all are in the ready queue. Okay. At 5, at ready queue, which are processes? P2, P3, P4. Now, which process will be scheduled for the run state? Decided by burst time. See, burst time is 331. 3, 3, 1. Which one is having least burst time? This P4. Now P4 will go for the execution, okay, and what is its burst time? It's 1, so till 6. Now P4 is over. Now P4 is over. Fine. At 6, which process is available in ready queue? You can see P2 and P3 are remaining. Now P2 and P3, 3 and 3, both have same burst time. Then who will go first? This is decided by, let's see, first we will check burst time. If burst time is same, then we will check arrival time. Fine. Which process arrived first, that will get chance to go first. Fine. So arrival time of P2 and P3, P2 arrived first, so P2 will be going for the execution. Okay, P2 having burst time 3, so 6 plus 3, 9. P2 will complete and P2 is over. Fine. Now P3 is remaining, so after that P3 will go and till 12. Fine. Till 12, all processes will be over. Now you have a question in your mind that, okay, let's burst time is same for the processes, then we will check arrival time. If arrival time is same, then what will happen? Then there is also a tiebreaker here. One is process ID, right? As we know that for each process, operating system creates a unique process identification number, or you can say process ID, which is unique. So if P2 and P3 is having same burst time, then P2 will go first. Least process ID will go first. Fine. So these are the tiebreakers. First which will burst time, then arrival time, then process ID. Now solve this question here. Fine. You can see completion time of P1 is 5. Okay. For P4 it's 6. Fine, 6. And for P2 it's 9. Fine, for P3 it's 12. Okay, 6 and 9 and 12. What is turnaround time? Turnaround time is nothing but completion time minus arrival time. So 5 minus 0, 5, 6 minus 1, 5, 9 minus 3. 9 minus 2, it's 7, 12 minus 4, it's 8. Okay. And what will be the waiting time? Waiting time is nothing but turnaround time minus burst time. 0, 2, 7 minus 3, 4, 8 minus 1, 7. Now you have completed your table. Now you can find anything like what is the turnaround time of P2 process is 5, waiting time 2, like that. And still you can find average waiting time, right? Average turnaround time. Sum of them divided by number of processes. Fine. So I am not calculating it. You can do it. Okay, fine. Shortest job first, criteria is burst time, and mode is non-preemptive. Now we will see if criteria is burst time. Okay, first delete this, then we will see. Okay, see, criteria is criteria is remaining bus time and mode is preemptive. What will happen? Remaining bus time. Why I am saying remaining bus time? Let's see situation here. Let's see, you have a run state, a ready state. Fine. Come on. Ready state. Fine. And this is your run state. Fine. What will happen? Let's say you have process P1, P0 and P1. Fine. So P0 is having burst time, let's say 5, and P1 is having burst time 10. So P0 will be scheduled to the run state. P0 is here now. Fine. P0 is scheduled here. P0 is running its CPU time. Now, let's say here a new process P2 is created, fine, and having burst time 1. Okay, created, and it will come to the ready state. Now, at any point of time like 1, at 0, P0, P0 and P1 were there, P1 was scheduled. Let's say at 1, what will happen? In ready queue, you have P1 and P2, and at run state, you have P0. P0 is still not over. Fine. P0 is still not over, and P2 is coming in the ready queue. Then what will happen? P2 will say, I have less burst time, I want to go first. Fine. This mode is preemptive. So what will happen? P0 will be preempted here. It will come here. Right? Okay. And it will come here and it will calculate that what is my remaining burst time. So 1 second is over. So 4 remaining. So P2 will scheduled from ready state to run state. Okay, and it will perform for 1 second. Like that, this preemption will happen. So let's see this example with preemption. Fine. And one thing more,